Welcome back to In the Garden. Joining us today on the Grange Co-op patio is Brandon from Grange Co-op, one of the experts in this field. So Brandon, right now we have pansies behind us. We have a whole display of things that could help these grow this fall season, but what makes these such a special and unique item to plant right now?
So pansies are an excellent flower to plant right now. As your petunias and verbena and other things like that are kind of going out of season, coming to the end of their season, pansies are just coming into their prime season. Get them planted now in fall, get some good growth on them, and they will last all winter, into spring, even into early summer. If you got a nice cool spot for them, they could even last longer.
And you talk about taking care of them. What's the upkeep, I'd say, on, you know, when you plant these in your garden, what can you expect and how often do you want to manage them?
So pansies don't need a whole lot of management, cool. Not like petunias where you have to fertilize weekly and spray weekly or anything like that. Pansies are going to be pretty easy. I always recommend using a bone meal and blood meal fertilizer. That's going to be one of the best options for pansies to throw in there when you're planting them. And then using a product called Sluggo Plus. The Sluggo Plus is going to help keep slugs.
This guy right here?
Yeah, this is going to help keep the slugs, the snails, the earwigs, sow bugs, pill bugs, all of that out of there. Is not only a bait, but also a killer for them as well. It is an organic, same as the bone meal and the blood meal there. So if you're wanting to keep an organic garden going, the Sluggo Plus is a safe product to use, as it is OMRI approved.
Awesome. And I know we've talked about some of the fertilizers that you can use. How would these benefit when you're planting the pansies in your garden?
Absolutely. If you don't want to do the bone meal and blood meal mix, as the blood meal has kind of a little bit of a pungent smell to it, you can use the GMB all-purpose fertilizer or the rose and flower food by GMB as well. All of those are going to be a decent fertilizer for the pansies, but if you really want the most out of your pansies, use a good blood and bone meal.
Awesome. Then when you're planting the pansies, how far apart do you want them from other plants, or how deep do you want to go when you're planting those guys?
So as you're planting, just like anything else in your garden, you don't want to go any deeper than they are in the container. Okay. A little bit extra wider of a hole. Hopefully, if you all have already prepped your garden bed, as most bedding plants, you want a nice, light, fluffy soil. So you want to make sure that you've already gone in there and tilled it up. Or raked it out, cultivated it, added some organic materials in there, and make sure that you got just a nice, light, fluffy area for those to go into.
All right, well, thank you, Brandon, for, you know, sharing what pansies are and pretty much how we could plant these in our garden and some of those benefits. But if you have any other questions about this specific plant or any of these products that you could use in your garden, you could head over to a Grange Co-op to buy some pansies or talk to an expert such as Brandon himself, or head to our website, kdrv.com.